Hi, everyone. Welcome to Kids Church Online. I'm Rebecca, the Kids Church pastor, and I'm so glad that you're here, ready to worship, ready to laugh, ready to learn. I know that some of you don't live close to Eagle Rock, and I love that this video makes it possible for us to connect. How amazing is that? And for those of you who do live close, we would love to see you here in person on the weekends at Kids Church. We really love being together. So come and join us. So, how many of you have had a really great summer? Did anyone go to the beach? How about a vacation? Did anyone go on vacation? On the count of three, shout out. Now, I know some of you may have gone on more than one, so pick one. And on the count of three, shout out where you went on vacation. One, two, three. It's awesome. That's awesome. I'm guessing that you got a lot of good pool time. You got a lot of play time, video game time, popsicle time. And I don't know about you, but I sometimes can get a little bummed when something fun, something that I've been enjoying, when it starts coming to an end. So I could let myself feel really bummed that summer is ending. I could even take it a step further and tell myself that nothing fun is ever going to happen again. A little dramatic, right? Of course, that's not true. All of that goodness that we experienced over the summer, all of it was a gift from God. And God isn't like, well, summer's over, the kids are going back to school, I'm done giving them good gifts. That's not what he's saying, right? Of course not. God is so good and he's so loving. And in the Bible, we see that he loves to bless his children in all sorts of ways. As you enjoy these last few weeks of summer, thank God for the ways he's been so good and kind by providing with such fun this summer. And look forward to what he has for you in the future. I promise, it's gonna be good. How do I know that? Because he is good. All right, enjoy Kids Church.
Hey, what's up, Kids Church? Welcome to our kid interview. Today, I have my friend Ella with us. Ella, will you tell Kids Church hi?
Hi.
Ella, I'm super excited to do this kid interview with you. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so our first question is, how old are you, when is your birthday, and what grade are you going into?
I'm 8 years old. My birthday is July 6th, and I'm going into third grade.
Awesome, so cool. All right, next question. Ella, it looks like we're in your room. Do you have something, like, what is your favorite thing in your room?
I have my shelf in my room, which is full of my books. That's my favorite thing.
Okay, do you happen to have a favorite book?
Yeah, well, I have a favorite book series.
Okay, what is it?
Imagination Station.
Well, thank you for sharing. Okay, our next question is, Ella, do you happen to have a hidden talent?
Maybe fast reading?
Okay, fast reading. Do you feel like you're faster than your sister or your parents?
Maybe faster than my sister.
Okay.
My parents can read faster than me.
Oh, okay. Ella, what would you like to do when you grow up?
I would like to be a scientist.
Ooh, okay. Tell me why you would want to be a scientist.
So maybe I can find out new medicines or something.
Okay, so you want to help people by finding out new medicines? Okay, so you could like, have you done any science projects like recently?
Like experiments?
Yeah.
Well, I do have this like chemistry kit or something, or a psychochemistry kit, and I made this rainbow in a bottle thing.
Oh, that sounds really cool. Next question, what are three words that you would use to describe yourself?
Funny, kind, and creative.
Funny, kind, and creative. Yes, I love it. I love that God's created you that way, and I love that you know that about yourself. That's so cool. Thank you, Ella. One of my favorite questions, if you could have any superpower, what would you have?
I actually have 3 superpowers I really want.
Okay, share them.
All of them?
Sure.
Shapeshifting, ice powers, and flying.
Ooh, shapeshifting, ice powers, and flying. Okay, if you could shapeshift into anything, what would you shapeshift into?
My parents.
Okay, why would you do that?
So I can sneak up and like pretend to be one of my parents so I can hear secret conversations.
Okay, so you want to hear what your parents are talking about. Okay, that's fun. That's really cool. Well, Ella, the interview has gone by super quickly, but it's been so fun to like get to hear your answers and get to know you better. This is our last question. Ella, if you could encourage Kids Church with one thing, what would it be?
To not fear, because the Lord your God is with you always.
Oh, yes, thank you for that encouragement. That to do not fear, because the Lord God is with you always. Yes, that is an encouragement for me and for Kids Church. So thank you so much, Ella. All right, we have one last thing to do. What is it?
Game time.
All right, count us down.
3, 2, 1, game time.
Hi, Kids Church. Now, in just a minute, we're going to worship God with our singing, which, as you guys know, it's one of my very favorite ways to worship. And I'm really glad that whether we're at home or here in Eagle Rock, we can worship God this way. And we also, just because we're home, it doesn't stop us from worshiping God with our offering. You know, it's a good thing to worship God by giving Him our money. He's asked us to do it, and we know that He only asks us to do things that are good. One of the reasons that giving a portion of our money is good is that it reminds us that God is more important than anything else in our lives. It also helps us remember to be thankful. It helps us remember where everything that we have comes from. It also helps us grow in the ways that we trust God to provide for us, that He'll provide everything that we need. So as we worship God with our voices over the next few minutes, I encourage you to also bring Him your worship offering.
just one word. You calm the storm that surrounds me. Just one word. The darkness has to retreat. Just one touch. I feel the presence of heaven. Just one touch. My eyes were open to see. My heart can't help but believe. There's nothing that our God can't do. There's not a mountain that He can't move. Oh, praise the name that makes a way. There's nothing that our God can't do. Just one word. You heal what's broken inside me.
Hello, everybody. I'm so glad you're here with us again at the Casey Family Experience. What's up? Hello. How you doing? Guys, this month is going to be a lot of fun because this month is all about creativity. Now, if you all know me, then you know that I love to be creative. I love creating songs, whether it's about a verse in the Bible or about Star Wars. I love to rap and sing, whether it's with Jacob Park, who's a worship leader here at CA, or with my puppet too. I love composing music, whether it's just with the guitar or using everyday items and turning them into an instrument, whatever. Guys, in this season, I've been trying my best to also create videos to make you all laugh, encourage you guys, and remind you all just how great our God is. At the end of the day, I just love that I can create, you know, something from just a thought and a feeling of ooh, this could be really cool if I made this. And then use whatever I made to enjoy and glorify God. God's creativity is imagining what you could do because you're made in God's image. God's creativity is indescribable. It has no limits. And since God created us to be like him, we can be creative too. If you all know me, then you also know that I love to be in awe of creation as well. Like, you ever just looked at a mountain or the ocean and just said to yourself, God is good? Or have you ever looked at a caterpillar and just said, wow, this is kind of weird, but at the same time, kind of cool. God is good. God created everything we see. Let's see what you know about all the things he made with the super fun game, all right? So guys, I'm gonna give you guys some like trivia questions. Are you all ready? Oh my goodness, guys, we continue to do this. One more time, are you all ready? Nice, all right, here we go. Question one, what is the number 29,029? Is it A, the number of species of animals? Is it B, the height of Mount Everest in feet? Or is it C, the number of active volcanoes in the world? All right, what do you guys think? A, B, or C? All right, make an answer. Here we go. The answer is B, the height of Mount Everest in feet. Okay, let's keep going, keep going. Question two, what is the largest animal believed to ever exist? Is it A, the Loch Ness Monster? Is it B, the great white shark? Or is it C, the blue whale? What do you guys think? All right, all right. Come on, come on. All right, make a guess. All right. The answer is C, the blue whale. Question three, what is the smallest known mammal? Is it A, the Etruscan shrew? Is it B, the chihuahua? Or is it C, the African pygmy hedgehog? All right. What do you guys think? Okay, okay. Make a guess, make a guess. All right, the answer is A, the Etruscan shrew. I know, I know. I was shocked too. Okay. Question four, what is the largest body of water in the world? Is it A, the Pacific Ocean? Is it B, the Atlantic Ocean? Or is it C, the Mississippi River? All right, what do you guys think? Some of you guys are like, oh, MJ, this is so easy. I know, I know, I know. You guys are smart. Okay, the answer is A, the Pacific Ocean. A, all right, one more, all right, here we go. What is the smallest ocean? Is it A, Indian Ocean? Is it B, the Southern Ocean? Or is it C, the Arctic Ocean? What do you guys say, what do you guys say? Again, you also were like, MJ, this is so easy. I know, I know, I know. It's okay. All right, the answer is C, the Arctic Ocean. Good job, guys. Give you all a round of applause. Pat on the back. You guys are smart. Guys, I also love it when we worship. I love when we sing to God and tell him how amazing he is. He is indescribable, and his creativity is indescribable too. We know that's true because we can see the incredible world he's made. Let's take a look at this video and learn about God's creation in the book of Genesis. See you guys after.
Stories of the Bible. Creation. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was empty, formless, and dark. But the Spirit of God was there. On the first day, God said, "Let there be light." And God saw that the light was good. Then he separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day and the darkness night. On the second day, God said, "Let there be a space to separate the waters of the heavens from the waters of the earth." God called the space sky. On the third day, God said, "Let the waters beneath the sky flow together into one place, so dry ground may appear." God called the dry ground land, and the waters seas. And God saw that it was good. Then God said,
let the land sprout with every sort of plant and tree. And God saw that it was good. On the fourth day, God said, let lights appear in the sky to separate the day from the night. God made two great lights, the sun for the day and the moon for the night. He also made the stars. God set these lights in the sky to light the earth, and God saw that it was good. On the fifth day, God said, let the waters swarm with fish and other life. Let the skies be filled with birds of every kind. And God saw that it was good. On the sixth day, God said, let the earth make every sort of animal. God made all sorts of wild animals, livestock and small animals, each able to have babies of the same kind. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, let us make man in our image, to be like us. So God created man in his own image. He formed man from the dust of the ground. He breathed the breath of life into man, and a man became alive. Then he saw that the man needed a helper, so God put man into a deep sleep, and while he slept, God took one of the man's ribs. Then God made a woman from the rib and brought her to the man.
Hello.
Hi.
Then God blessed them and said, be fruitful and multiply. Fill the earth and rule over it. Rule over the fish in the sea.
Hello, man.
The birds in the sky.
Hello, bird.
And all the animals that scurry along the ground. Then God said, look, I have given you every plant throughout the earth and all the fruit trees for your food. And I have given you every green plant as food for all the animals. Then God looked over all he had made, and he saw that it was very good. So the creation of the heavens and the earth and everything in them was done. So on the seventh day, God rested from all his work. And God blessed the seventh day and said it was holy.
Awesome, guys. Well, from nothing, God created everything. There's no limit to God's creativity. As much as we might try to describe God, he is truly indescribable. His creation shows us how amazing he is. We can know him because we can see the amazing world he made. It's amazing how God made everything we see and everything we know. God created it all. And remember, God didn't just create us. He wants a relationship with each one of us. That's why he sent Jesus to be our Savior. God wants a relationship with you guys, which is why he created you. There's no limit to God's creativity. Can you guys say that with me? There's no limit to God's creativity. In fact, God's creativity is so huge that it's hard for us to even understand. In Psalm 145:3, David put it this way. Lord, you are great. You are really worthy of praise. No one can completely understand how great you are. Here's one thing I do understand, though. I can trust God no matter what. I can't always understand him or even know everything about him, but I can trust him. Man, I feel like that's something I really need to know right now. And that might be the most indescribable thing of all. So guys, this week, take time to look around at all the things God's created. So the next time you guys go on a walk or you get in the car to go somewhere, just be very intentional to look around at all the amazing things God created. Say, God is good. Maybe if you guys have a pet, you know, maybe looking at your pet, you know, maybe not awkwardly staring at it, but just looking at it and be like, wow, God created this and he is good. Or maybe that's looking in the mirror, saying, God created me. And reminding yourself that he just didn't create you, but that he wants to have a relationship with you as well. And that's amazing. Let's pray now and thank him for being such an amazing creator. Let's pray. Dear God, what you have made is good, so, so good. We're thankful that we can see your limitless creativity in everything you've made. You made each one of us, and you love us. Please help us to see how good you are as we look at the world around us and the people you've put in our lives. We love you, and we pray these things in Jesus' precious name. Amen.
Hi, friends. We hope you enjoyed today's Kids Church family experience. Today's riddle is, what do you call a cat who loves to swim? A catfish. Have a great week.